Es lebten einmal sechs kleine Meerprinzessinnen mit ihrem Vater, dem Meerkönig, und ihrer Großmutter in einem Palast tief im Meere. Die jüngste Meerprinzessin war die schönste und sehnte sich danach, aus dem Meere emporzutauchen und die Wunder der Menschenwelt zu bestaunen. An ihrem 15. Geburtstag würde sie dies zum ersten Mal tun dürfen. Endlich kam der Tag, an dem sie aus dem Meer auftauchen durfte und ein großes Seeschiff im roten Wasser entdeckte. Aus Tanz und Menschen. Am schönsten von allen war ein junger Prinz. Er ging zu tanzen und sangen und kam ein fürchterlicher Sturm auf. Das Schiff kenterte und sank auf dem Meeresgrund. Ein Prinz wohl erinnerte sich daran, dass Menschen nicht im Wasser gehen, weil er eben ihren Traum in Schutz, in den Schnee erreicht wurde. Und was haben wir? Dort stand ein Wassertempel. Korn und Masilien kamen her und die Samen wurden überzogen. Ein Volk.
Og prøvede at få barnet, sagde hun. Men ingen vidste, hvilke smukke ting hun havde set. There was once a poor but handsome prince who wanted to get married. Although his kingdom was small, there were hundreds of princesses who would have been glad to say yes, but he wanted to marry the emperor's daughter. The prince had a nightingale, which sang as if every lovely melody in the world was in its throat, and a beautiful rose tree that bore only one blossom every 5 years. But it was so sweet that whoever smelled it forgot all sorrows and cares. The rose and the nightingale were put into great silver caskets and presented to the princess. But the princess rejected them both, for she was more interested in artificial playthings. The prince, however, would not be put off by her rejection. He stained his face brown and black, pulled his hat down over his eyes, and obtained a job at the emperor's palace as the imperial swineherd. He worked busily all day, and by the evening he had made a beautiful little cooking pot. When it boiled, it played a lovely tune, and by holding one's finger in the steam, one could immediately smell all the dinners that were being cooked on every stove in town. The princess was enchanted by it.
How much do you want for the pot?
Asked the lady-in-waiting. 10 kisses from the princess, or I keep my pot, said the prince. When the prince took his 10 kisses from the princess, the pot was hers. Then the prince made a rattle which, when swung around, played all the waltzes, galops, and jig tunes that have ever been played since the world began. This time, though, the prince wanted 100 kisses from the princess. When the emperor saw the swineherd take his 86th kiss, he was furious and ran out of his realm. So there she stood in front. Many years ago, there was an emperor who was so fond of clothes that he spent all his money on them. In fact, he had a costume for every hour of the day. One day, two swindlers came to visit him. They told him that they were weavers who knew how to weave the most beautiful fabrics imaginable. In fact, they were so fine that they were invisible to anyone who was a fool or unfit for office. Those must be splendid clothes, thought the emperor. By wearing them, I shall be able to distinguish the wise men from the fools. He paid the swindlers a lot of money to proceed with the weaving, but they put it all into their own pockets. Not a single strand was ever put into the loom. While the two swindlers worked away on the empty loom, the emperor sent first one of his faithful ministers, then another, to report on the progress of the work. Though neither of them could see any fabric, they did not wish to be seen as fools and reported back to the emperor that the fabric was magnificent.
Ik heb een foto van Hans Christian Andersen. Hallo.